The Morning Mess.
Morning Mess, time for another one. Staycation setup time. Can we say good morning to Courtney?
Good morning.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Courtney. So what's going on with you and Michael?
I'm worried he might be cheating on me. We've been dating for about a year. Normally things are fine. He's just seemed a little bit distant. You know, just doesn't text me as much, doesn't hang out with me as much, it seems like. But I also wasn't really worried about it because, you know, it's been a year. You know, we're not honeymooning anymore, you know what I mean?
Uh-huh. Right.
So, whatever. I didn't really think that much of it.
He's allowed to have a space.
Yeah. But the other day, we were hanging out, and I noticed he got a notification on his phone, and it looked like the flame from Tinder.
Okay, oh. So if you don't know what she means, so the whole, like, icon for Tinder is a fire. Like, it's like a little flame emoji-looking thing.
Okay.
So that is really weird for your man to have that. Did you ask him about that notification when you saw it?
So, look, I do not play with this type of stuff. You know what I mean? And I do not have time. Do not waste my time. So right then and there, I said to him, you know, what was that little notification? That looked like a Tinder notification to me. And he goes, oh, no, babe. You know, I've been trying to get in shape or whatever, and it's this app I use that tells me how many calories I burnt.
Huh.
Did he prove it? Like, did he show you the app?
No. He told me that. He put his phone in his pocket, didn't take his phone out again the rest of the night. I mean, I'm not trying to be paranoid and stuff, you know what I mean? But also, just my spidey sense is just, So I was like, all right, you know what? Let me go on the app store and see if I can see a calorie burning app that has
the same emoji or the same icon. Did you find something with it?
Nope.
Oh.
Wow.
No, I did not.
Okay.
I mean, he is burning calories just with somebody else is what it comes down to.
Oh, my God.
So he's kind of lightweight, not lying?
No.
He better not be.
And if he is?
That's it.
I mean, I will say there are some apps that are a little harder to find on the App Store. Maybe you were not looking for the right thing. It kind of sounds about right, like a calorie burner.
I mean, I hope I was wrong.
Oh, obviously. Have you maybe snooped through his phone? I don't know if you have his passcode.
No, I really don't. But I mean, I also don't want to be doing stuff like that.
Well, you're calling the Morning Mess to try to bust my liar on the radio, so.
Yeah.
I mean, you got there. You know what? Let's just do the staycation setup. What we're going to do for you, Courtney, is call up Michael. We're going to offer him a free romantic hotel stay. After that, we're going to ask him who he wants to put on the reservation. Obviously, if he says your name, Courtney, there's no problem. If he says another girl's name, there lies a problem. We're just going to eavesdrop while you give it to him.
Okay.
Counseling services are available on standby, girl, but we'll call your man up and find out once and for all. Staycation setup is up next with the Morning Mess.
Staycation set up, Morning Mess here. We spoke to Courtney. She suspects her man Michael of cheating. She saw a little alert from his phone. You're very familiar with this alert, Courtney. It's the flame like emoji from the Tinder app, but he tried to say it's a different type of app that lets him know about burning calories. Is that what it is?
That is what he said, but I did not see any app like that.
Because you did your research.
Yes, I did.
And he's lying on his bed. With
oh
another girl.
God.
That's what I said from the beginning. Because why? Michael's a cheater's name.
We don't know that for sure. Michael is not. That is my cousin's name. Don't do
that. He's a cheater.
We're trying to find out if that's what your man is, girl. I know that you've got suspicion, so let's go ahead and confirm it with the staycation setup. We're going to call him up right now. I'm going to pretend to be that hotel clerk, offer him the free romantic weekend stay, and then I'm going to ask who he wants to bring for that free romantic weekend. Only name he should say is yours. Now, Courtney, if he says anybody else's, we've got counseling services on standby, and you can let him have it, okay?
Thank you.
Here we go.
Hello.
Hello, am I speaking with Michael?
Yeah, how can I help you?
Michael, hi, my name is Jonathan. I'm actually calling with some really good news for you. You've been selected as the grand prize winner of our free romantic weekend giveaway. We're going to put you up in our penthouse suite with our honeymoon package. I was actually calling just to confirm some details, but I wanted to congratulate you on being our grand prize winner.
I'm good, man.
I mean, this is a free romantic weekend stay, so if you have somebody that you really appreciate in your life, you can give this to them as a way of showing how much they mean to you. There's no deposits, fees, or taxes.
Just seems like not a really good time right now with everything going on, so it'd be kind of weird to just do it now.
So I completely understand that. Hoping that we could get you in here, review your experience, and can even schedule you out into the far future if that's what would make you feel more comfortable.
Okay, man, that's cool. Yeah.
Thank you very much, Michael. The first thing that we do is we leave the guest of honor a personalized note that comes from you. Because this is a free romantic weekend stay, I wanted to see if you had a special message for your guest.
I don't know, just leave something basic. You know, like, anything's fine. It's no one special.
So then my next question for you is, who would you like to bring on this free romantic weekend stay?
Can you do her first name? Is that okay?
Sure.
All right, Jerrica?
Who the f*** is Jerrica?
Hey, Michael, before we get to your girl, Courtney, who's on the line, we legally got to let you know we're the Morning Mess, and you're live on the radio right now.
Better tell me something right now.
Babe, relax.
Tell
relax,
me
relax.
Something.
It's a joke. It's not that serious. I wasn't going to actually
joke. A joke.
Joking around.
You meet this on Tinder, right?
This She's is not
some
even real.
Random right?
She's not even real. I just,
why would you do that?
Just for giggles. I don't know. I just do it because the guy was asking. I was just like, whatever.
You sound
I didn't care. I was going to go.
Right now. You know what? I told your ass if I caught you cheating, that would be it. I told you.
Courtney, do you know a Jerrica?
No, I don't know no Jerrica.
Look, are we really doing this over the
yes,
radio? Like,
would,
if you really want to
no,
break up over this...
Are you really doing this?
I'm not doing anything. You can't say I'm doing anything if I'm not doing anything.
No, you clearly are. I mean, I made it very clear that this was a free romantic weekend stay. You said that this was someone named Jerrica. You have Tinder on your phone.
I don't have Tinder on my phone. That's that stupid calorie burner where it gives you notifications like, yo, you need to do some push-ups and stuff like that. That's all it is.
Okay. Okay.
If that was true, then why couldn't she find that app on the App Store?
Yes, thank you.
She has an Android and I have an Apple. You know,
oh, come on.
Apples are better. Courtney, listen, is the joke gone too far? I'm sorry. I care for you. I think we should talk it out, not on the radio, and then, you know, just figure everything out from there. But I am not cheating.
I just can't believe you would do that.
I'm not cheating.
We have counseling services if you guys are both interested in working this out.
Courtney, for real, though, like, whatever these little, like, games that they play and all that, it's...
Okay. Courtney, you seem to be doing a lot of listening. Are you taking them back?
Yeah, because we're going to talk about it without you guys interfering. We'll figure things out. We're good together.
I mean, okay.
Courtney, you are not forgiving him right now.
What?
I think we should take the counseling.
But you do know he was cheating, though, right?
I don't know. I mean, maybe I was...
Babe, you know I love you. I'm not going to
cheat. He's not going to cheat anymore.
I'm not cheating on him.
Who was better?
Why would you ask that? They're trying to work on their relationship now.
He's lying to her.
I'm going to come over tonight, all right? I'll have to work. I'm going to shoot over. I'm going to talk.
He's going to shoot.
All right.
Told you, baby. We don't need these people messing our relationship up.
What's that, Michael? Jerrica was better? Oh, Courtney.
What?
I don't think you should take him back. He's still having these fantasies about this girl, Jerrica, man. You don't need this counseling service. The best way to get over somebody is to get under somebody. And the best way to get under somebody is if their last name or first name is in Michael. So I think... You need to move on. You don't need this counseling. You need a new in your life.
I mean...
Listen, Courtney. You need to leave this man. Do you understand? On this other hand, there's another man.
They're just messing with you. They're just trying to get you riled up so you just say something. I'm telling you, I'm not cheating. We should talk it out and work on it.
Courtney.
I want to try the counseling.
Stupid is, stupid does.
Stop!
See? You see what I mean?
See, you see? Who said that? Was that Michael? He called you stupid. You saw that?
All right.
They turn on you.
Don't give no damn counseling services.
What? We have to.
I mean, we could be going under a tunnel right now.
Oh,
you guys!
We're losing connection. Courtney, you there?
The Morning Mess.